This video tutorial shows you how to use the e-commerce feature of websites.co.in. The first step is you have to log into your web dashboard or else your mobile app. Once you're logged in, from the side navigation bar, go into the stores and settings. Under the settings, you'll see this enable e-commerce option. So this is an option you can use to enable or disable e-commerce feature on your website. So if it's disabled, I'll enable that. Okay, I can choose the currency. So this is the currency in which the products will appear on my site. So it's INR, so I just, you know, let it be the way it is. The next thing is the tax. So here I have a provision to configure the taxes that I have applicable for the products that people buy from me. So let's say I have the GST as the tax and I choose percentage. And 18. So here you can configure multiple taxes applicable for your products. Then you move on to your payment section. So this is where you can configure your check, your two payment options that you have. The first is pay by check and direct bank deposit, and the second option is the payment gateway. Currently, websites.co.in platform supports only Razorpay payment gateway. So in order to use the e-commerce feature and in order to have the payment gateway option on your site, you have to sign up with Razorpay and obtain the API key as well as the API secret. So let's say once you have your Razorpay account all set and you have the API key and your API secret handy with you, you can just paste it out over here. So I'll just paste it out. And I click on save. Next, I'll configure the check and direct deposit option. So I'll use my bank name. So Swift, in case you have payments, you would be receiving payments from international customers, you would require the Swift account. So you'll have to contact your bank to obtain the Swift ID of your bank. So let's say your and this is where you can, show some instructions for your customers while they are making the payment for you. So let's say I display. And finally, the shipping options. So currently, you can just set the weight units as well as the dimensions. So I'm okay with my kilograms as the weight unit, and I'll set inches as my dimension unit. So, well, you have your e-commerce settings configured. So once you have this, next you have to migrate to your product section. You can review your existing products and correct the inventory, the quantities you have for the product, as well as the other pricing options. And in case there are some changes, you can make them. In my case, I don't see any products added at the moment, so I'll just go ahead and add a new product. So let's say I have one product called Ethernet switch. So these are the options I have. So currency, the currency that you have set in the settings option will override the currency over here. So you can set the settings. I mean, you can check your currency in the settings section. Let's say your product is fixed price. Currently, the e-commerce option is available only for the fixed price products. So I set my price as 100 rupees, or let's say 2000 rupees. And I am offering no discount for this product. I have in stock, let's say 10 items available. And for this, I'm keeping free shipping. So that's it. I can go ahead and publish my product. I'll add one more product, and this time I'll have some discount for the product. So let's say the Ethernet cable. And over here I have it as 1000 rupees and the discount amount as, I keep a 10% discount. In stock I have, let's say 20 units. And the shipping charges I would keep as 100 rupees. And that's it. I go ahead and publish the product. So now these products would appear on my site. As you can see, I have this e-commerce symbol now available, the shopping cart feature available on my website. So I have two products to choose from. So let's say the customer chooses the Ethernet switch as well as an Ethernet cable. And I see the products have been added to my cart. I can alter the quantities. So let's say I need two quantities of Ethernet cables and one Ethernet switch. I see the shipping charges. The first product is zero and the shipping charges in the second product is 200. The tax also calculated correctly over here. And I go ahead and place the order. So I configure my details. So so in case you have a different shipping address, you can just uncheck this. And in my case, the shipping address as well as the billing address are same. So I see there are two payment methods available. Check by credit card, pay by credit card, debit card, net banking. And the other option is pay via check. So in case I pay via check, I would see the payment options, the instructions to make the payment via check. And once I continue shopping, my order has been placed. So once the order is successfully placed, you can see the shopping cart turns empty and you can navigate back to your dashboard and you can see the order section. The order is received in your dashboard, and the user has received an email with the orders that he have and the current status. So as you can see, since the user selected to pay by bank transfer option, the status is unpaid. So now you can go and visit the section action, and this is where you can see the details where, you know, the order is to be shipped, what all things have the user ordered, and the entire order summary with all the pricing and taxes calculations. And this is where you can update the status. So currently you see it's unpaid. So now let's say I mark as the paid, and after every status change, I can choose whether to send an email to the customer or not. So if I check this, the customer will get notified through an email. So this is where, you know, the customer will get a notification that the payment is received. Okay, so now I can see the customer made the payment, the amount got credited. So you have other statuses. So once you have received the payment, I can see other statuses. Let's say I mark it as processed. And once it's processed, I ship the ship the products. So you can see all those statuses, all those statuses are getting recorded with all the exact dates and the timing. So eventually when the user gets the item delivered, I can choose delivered. In case the user cancels the order, you can choose the canceled option. So these are the statuses you have, and this is the e-commerce feature of websites.co.in. So